This is Susie Q of Susie Q's Happy Little Haven, and welcome to my nursery room window. So today I have Tiffany Rose with me, and Tiffany Rose is the tiny little tink sculpt by Bonnie Brown. And she's wearing her Christmas outfit, and I'm going to be changing her out of her Christmas outfit and into a another outfit that's still, it's a knitted outfit, it's wintry, but it's not Christmassy. Gradually, I'm going to be changing all my babies out of their Christmas outfits and into their winter outfits. And so Tiffany Rose is the second one that I've changed, or that I'll be changing. And so let me put her down right here and show you what I'm going to be changing her into. And some of you, a lot of you will recognize this outfit. I just love it on her. It was one of the first outfits that I ever got for her. It's knitted. It's a hand-knitted outfit. I got it from Etsy, from a lady that knitted it. And it's super, super cute. All of the buttons work. They all have buttons and buttonholes. And that's the front. And there's the back. And then it, she also made a hat to go with it. And I added this hairband bow to it because I thought it looked really cute to have that. And so she made that, as well as she made these little booties. So that's what Tiffany Rose is going to be wearing today. And underneath it all is going to be this cute little onesie. It's got some flowered hearts on it, or a heart with flowers on it, and it says beautiful, which is what she is. She's a little bit of perfection. I really love this sculpt. She's so, I always say this, she's so tiny and fragile. She's the smallest of all of my babies. So I'm going to move her up a bit, because one of the last times that I changed her, she was so far behind in the back here that I don't feel like anyone could see her very well. So I'm going to put her more up front here. There's plenty of room on the changing table for her. And so what I'm going to do at the same time when I'm changing her is I am going to be doing a New Year's tag. And I made up some questions to a tag that I thought would be fun for all of my Dolly friends to do, those with channels and those without channels. You're welcome to do this tag. And I thought it'd just be fun because New Year's is just right around the corner. And so let's go ahead and get started with that while I get her change. And it's actually 10 questions. And so question number one, do you stay up until midnight on New Year's Eve? And for me, it's not a tradition for me to stay up until midnight. Sometimes I try to stay up until midnight, but usually I end up going to bed because it just gets too late. And the answer to that question is usually not. Number two, have you ever held or attended a New Year's Eve party? And do you have a favorite one worth remembering? I can't remember attending a New Year's Eve party, but my husband and I, when we lived in California, we used to put parties on all the time at our house, and it was what they were family gatherings of family and friends. And We had one that was really, really neat that I remember. It was in the 90s, and I think, 1993, I think it was, and we had our, our very, like, our closest friends and our family, and we just had a huge house full of people, and we happened to have, it was a two-story house, and we had a pool table upstairs, so the guys kind of went upstairs. Some of the girls did too, and played some pool. And while others of us, we stayed downstairs and just talked and stuff. And then we played a game that we all enjoyed. It was a really fun game. It was the one where it's called Win, Lose, or Draw. You know, where you have teams. We separated into teams of girls and guys, and so it's the game where you are where the teams each of the people get up and they draw a picture, and the opposite team has to try to guess what it is. I think that's how it goes. Or maybe it's the members of the same team have to draw what it is. I probably should have looked that up before I talked about it. But anyway, it was really a fun game, and we had a great time. And I'm sure that night that we all stayed up and brought the new year in. Let's see, number three. Do you watch a New Year's Eve countdown to midnight entertainment TV program? I like to watch those programs. Sometimes, like I said, I don't stay up late enough to watch the big New Year's Eve ball come down in New York, but I do like to watch the shows because there's always a lot of fun entertainment. You know, like mainly people that are singing and stuff like that. So it's really an enjoyable show, and I always used to watch the one. The one that my favorite one is the one for those of you in America, and I don't know about other, you know, people in other countries, but Dick Clark was always my favorite channel to watch. He always did such a nice, a really good show, but he passed away, and then there was another guy, I forget his name. He's a TV personality that he took over Dick Clark's show. So that's the one that I like to watch. Okay, number four. Do you wear party hats or do you pop party poppers to bring in the new year? And no, I don't do that. I'm really not a party person per se. I do like to get together with small groups of people and stuff, but I don't. Like to, I'm just kind of like I'm a very much an introverted person. And so I don't like to wear hats and things like that. You know, but you know, I do have fun watching other people do it because there are some people that really super enjoy that. You know, wearing the party hats and doing the blowout whistle things and popping the party poppers and stuff like that. Anyway, it's not for me, but I sure enjoy watching other people do that. Let's see, number six. Do you make New Year's resolutions? If so, do you end up keeping any of the resolutions that you make? I used to make New Year's resolutions, but then I found that I never kept them. I don't make New Year's resolutions anymore, but I do have goals that I set for myself. So I don't know that that's a resolution or not, but I do set goals for myself during the year. Number seven, what was the best thing that happened to you this year or to your family? You know, I have a lot of little things that came up during the year, but there was one thing in particular that was really super neat that it happened quite recently, and so that's why I remember it so well. It's a silly thing, but it just really meant a lot to me. So I was shopping, my husband and I were shopping at a store, you know, our usual once a month shopping, and it was during the time that we you know, everybody was you know, piling up on toilet paper and paper towels and napkins, and there was just no paper goods available, you know. And so one time we had gone shopping and I was looking for toilet paper and I couldn't find any toilet paper. The shelves were empty and I just couldn't believe it because, you know, I thought, well, what am I going to do? And I had told my husband about it, like when we were shopping, I kind of mentioned it to him. I said, well, why in the world would the toilet paper be gone? Like, what's up with that? And, you know, like stuff like that. And there was a lady that happened to hear us, and she had a couple of package of big 12 roll toilet paper packages in her cart, and she offered me one. And I couldn't believe it. You know, she said, no, go ahead and, you know, would you like to have this one. She said she had a lot of rolls at home, and she offered me that one, and I just couldn't believe how nice of a thing that that was, you know, in these days and times. And so I know it's a silly thing, but you know, it kind of really touched my heart that someone would be so kind to do that, and it really, really made my day. So anyway, that was really neat. Number eight, what made you feel worthwhile this past year? Well, there's something that is happening on my channel that I wasn't aware of, but I'm finding out from what my Dolly friends are telling me. Now, I love to make these videos, and you know, they're a lot of fun, and you know, and I do hope that other people that are watching enjoy them as well. But what really makes my day is when someone gives me a comment and says, you know, they're having a particularly bad day, and my video, you know, something about my video cheered them up, you know, those type of things. And so that really, really makes my day, and makes me feel worthwhile that, you know, I'm having fun, but I'm also helping other people sometimes that are watching. And so that gives me a very good feeling of self-worth, that I'm at least, you know, helping some people get through the day. And so I love that. I love when I hear comments like that. It just really, you know, gets to my heart. Let's see, number nine. Do you have a project or goal that you've been putting off that you want to get done in the coming year? Yes, I do. like I said, it's not a New Year's resolution, but I really want to get my attic closet that I have over at the farmhouse. It's really needs to be gone through, and things need to be given away. And so I want to do that. And I want to start going through my baby clothes closets and storing all the seasonal clothes, so that the regular, you know, the through the year clothes aren't so crowded in there. So those are a couple of things that I'd like to do. And number 10, the last one, what are you most grateful for this past year? And I would say my number one most grateful thing has been my health. My husband and I have, knock on wood, and have been blessed with good health this year. And so that's what I'm most grateful for. And I do feel for those. My heart goes out for those that have gotten sick, or their families have gotten sick, and people have actually passed away from this virus. And so my most grateful feelings are to so far that I've had, my husband and I have had good health. So, but anyway, that is the last of the questions, and I'm going to put the all the 10 questions down in my details, so that you'll have an easy time. You don't have to write them down. And what do you think of Tiffany Rose? Don't you love this outfit? I just love her in this. And what I'm going to do, Ruth Beck is a very kind lady. She's a friend that made this blanket, and she also made Tiffany Rose some little dresses and hats and things too. Not this particular one, but she has some that she made. So I'm going to wrap Tiffany Rose up in this blanket because of the fact that her little legs are so bare. But look at how tiny she is. She is amazingly fragile and tiny. So I'm going to put her in her blanket made by her Auntie Ruth. And I think what's really neat about this blanket is that it goes, Ruth put so many different colors in it that it goes with absolutely everything that she wears, which is really cool. So anyway, everyone, that's all I wanted to share with you today. I hope you enjoyed my video, and for those of you that don't have a channel, if you want to participate in the New Year's tag, you know, if you want to answer a couple of the questions or all of the questions, it's entirely up to you. And anyway, thank you for visiting today. And until we meet again, bye-bye.